It is time now for Better Money with Joel Johnson, and today we are talking about three things to consider when you are offered a lump sum payout from your pension. Joel is a certified financial planner and managing partner at Johnson Brunetti, meaning like some companies might be offering you a lump sum instead of continuing those pension payments for the rest of your life.
Right, and tons of companies are doing this now, because what happens is if they promise those monthly payments, they have to carry that as a debt, a future debt, on their books. And accountants don't want to do that for big corporations. They would rather just offer a lump sum. And what we're talking about today is it really in someone's best interest, if they have that offer from their company, to take a lump sum or take that stream of payments?
Okay, and I guess it's going to depend. So we have three factors to consider if you've been offered a lump sum payment. The first one would be your retirement income and your essential living expenses.
Correct. We want to figure out what are essential living expenses. What are they? What does it cost to live every month? How much cash do we want coming into the house to pay bills and to do things that we want to do? If those expenses are much lower than what your monthly payment would be from a pension, let's say your expenses are $2,000 a month and your pension is going to be $4,000 a month, you're just getting extra money you're going to pay taxes on. So then maybe you should roll that money over and you can reduce the income, have that nest egg build up with proper investment.
Okay. At number two, your life expectancy. That's a hard one to figure out.
That's a hard one to figure out. And this is where, you know, if you don't want the investment risk and if you've got longevity in your family and you're really healthy, you might want to take those monthly payments, because remember, they're guaranteed for life. You live to be 110, they're still sending you that monthly check. And that's actually insured by the federal government if you've worked for a for-profit company.
Okay. And the third point would be, do you want to pass money to your heirs? And how does that work even? The pension doesn't go to them, right?
The pension cannot go to the heirs. So you have to take that lump sum, you roll it over into an individual retirement account. That's not a taxable transaction. Now you create your own monthly checks if you need monthly income out of there. You have to invest the money. You have to do a good job investing the money. But whatever's left over when you die can go to your heirs. This is why most people, or this is one of the reasons why most people roll over that lump sum into an IRA where they can control the way they take the money out. It's just, it's an asset now. It's not just a stream of payments.
Okay. So there's a lot more information than we have time to go into right here. But you have a free offer for people, and it's actually called the Lump Sum Pension Guide. So you want to read this and make some decisions before you let the company know what you're going
to
do.
Right. It's a number of things that we need to know about to help you make that decision. It simplifies the decision. It also talks about other places where you might be getting retirement income. This is a decision that needs to be made in the context of everything else somebody has going on.
So you need to go to bettermoneytv.com, and that's where you can get the free offer, and you'll send it out to the viewers.
We'll send it out. We'll also answer any email questions that they ask after getting and reading through the book.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Joel.
Thanks, Kara.
That's Better Money.